Kellinger.com. I'm here with Killinger. How you guys doing?
Good. How you doing, Peter?
Not too bad.
Awesome.
A brief history on the band.
Brief
and
history.
We're sort of Killinger, you know, got to start.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we started in 2009, so we haven't been around that long.
A few years.
Started out, you know, myself and the original singer of the band, Dave Williams, who is not on this tour right now because of illness. But we started the band, and it's evolved to the point where we've been touring a fair bit lately. This is our second tour this year, 2012, with Black Label Society. And we're enjoying life.
Oh yes, yeah. Enjoying Vancouver and the rain.
Yes,
and the green.
A lot of rain.
And a lot of rain.
Snow.
But it's better than the snow.
Oh yes. And being from Alberta, we got lots of that.
Yeah. Oh, we did. Yeah. We had a lot of snow.
Yeah. Do you guys want to talk about your new album and sort of the concept behind it? Yeah, you guys have sort of a hard rock metal from the 80s sound, so...
Late 80s? You know,
King Cobra type, Striper-ish?
There's definitely an influence of that when you listen to the album, and definitely, you know, myself, some of my biggest influences are guitar, you know, heroes from the 80s. I grew up listening to, you know, Eddie Van Halen, George Lynch, Michael Schenker, Uli Roth, those types, and I know a lot of folks say that comes through listening to the record. It's a very much a guitar heavy album.
Yeah.
In fact, we even get George Lynch to play a tune on the album.
Oh, very cool.
And which is great. You know, we have a singer that certainly has sort of an inclination to styles of the 80s.
Yeah.
He's got his own unique style for sure.
Yeah.
And he's a great singer, and he knows how to pelt it out for sure.
And you guys worked with Mike Fraser.
Yes.
Who engineered your album?
Yeah, and Mike was down last night.
Oh, he was.
He came out.
Oh yes.
Nice. It was great to see him. You know, he really likes our sound.
Yeah.
And he really brought an extra sort of level of polish to the record.
Absolutely. Yeah.
He's production.
Yeah. You know, he's worked with, you know, Metallica, all the sort of big
AC/DC.
Bands.
AC/DC,
man.
Oh yeah, he's done so many U2. The list goes on and on. He's done so many good bands, and even Aerosmith.
Isn't
that
amazing?
Yeah. They got a new album out, and they're going on tour. So, or they've been on tour.
Yeah. Doing mixes with a friend,
so,
and they would pull up.
So we're doing an interview. Yeah.
He was asking me about Hey Jude.
They got their own interview going.
I just got an interview too there.
Well, do you guys want to talk about your video, Holding On?
What would you like to know?
Who came up with the idea of the concept of the video, and how did the shoot go?
Well, yeah, Mark Ricciardelli is the director of that video, and he...
Do you approach
he listened
you,
to the
or?
Album, and well, he had a great idea, you know.
Okay.
He listened to the song. He thought, you know, we could really make this into a bit of over the top sort of 80s influenced
MTV style.
And that's what he came up with. And I loved it. I loved the idea.
He had never done a rock band like you. He's done pretty much all Alexis on Fire stuff, right?
Oh, okay.
And the Cancer Bats stuff like that.
Yeah.
So for him to get the concept of what we were coming after, he had a good vision, you know.
Mm-hmm.
The video turned out great, man. We shot it all in Toronto at a huge warehouse where they filmed Saw 2, I think.
Okay.
The washroom scene and stuff like that. It was all done in one location, which was great.
How long was the shoot for?
16 hours.
16 hours.
Yeah.
Wow.
Pulled it off, you know. And at that time, that's the first time, I mean, that was actually our first rehearsal as a band. at that time. We never we didn't even have a chance to rehearse after the album was recorded and done. Next thing you know, we all flew down to Toronto, met at a hotel, and the next day we're shooting a video.
Yeah.
So that was pretty cool. It worked well.
Yeah, I mean, I think it looks pretty good for what you guys have done, you know, for 16 hours. So.
Yeah, it was tiring.
No doubt. No doubt. I noticed on your bus, on your tour bus, you had a Foy Tonic. What is that?
Well, that's that is a drink, actually. So it's our own brand of energy drink.
Okay.
But it's not really an energy drink per se. It's actually, we call it an action drink.
Action drink.
Yes. And the reason why it's called that is because it doesn't have any caffeine in it. It doesn't have any taurine in it. It doesn't have any of the other stuff that typically energy drinks have in them. It's essentially is a formulation of pure Korean ginseng.
Okay.
So it's
actually good for you.
It's good for you.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
It's very good for you.
For me, it allows me to focus a lot better.
When you're on stage and just in general.
Daily, you know?
Yeah.
And to keep up with these 20-year-olds that we tour with.
So you drank a lot last night then?
I drank some last night, absolutely. But it also mixes great with vodka, with Jägermeister, or with colas.
Wow.
It really does.
JD.
Or actually one of the guys in the other bands was mixing vodka Mountain Dew in it. Which was, he said it was pretty tasty. I haven't tried that one, so I mean, it's something that's good for you, so why not try it in pretty much everything? I wouldn't put it in beer, but you never know. Maybe you do shooters.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's good stuff, man. I mean, it cures a hangover for me.
So can you buy it in stores, or do you have to go to the website?
Amazon.com.
Amazon.com.
It's available on that.
Or check out your website, maybe you could, you know.
Yeah.
Yes.
Go to killingtorocks.com, you know, and check it out. It's right there on the page. Click the link and you can buy it there.
So we're hoping that it's going to come out retail sort of establishments very soon.
How long has it been on the market, or?
We've had Health Canada approval and FDA approval for about a year now.
Okay.
Yeah. So we brought it out on our tour with Volbeats and Hell Yeah.
And they're drinking the case at a time.
Oh, man, we went through thousands of
bottles. We gave it out to all the fans.
Crazy.
Oh,
cool.
And they love it. I mean, we get a lot of good feedback about it.
Absolutely.
And on this tour as well.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the name Foy Tonic is a coined word, right? It's got an acronym in it, Foy, which is Fountain of Youth. And it's
I'm actually 80 years old.
The truth be known.
I'm 102.
And he's the youngest one in the band.
Damn, good looking.
This guy
we got from Iceland.
Only because they thawed me out, actually.
Yeah. Time. He was the mixture between Neanderthal man and the Vikings. He was the first Viking.
His first tour was with Chubby Checker, actually.
I thought it was with Beethoven.
Okay, that's
right. Yeah.
He's a good dude, that guy. He could play some piano.
Yes.
This is one of the things about you know, I think touring is that it takes a lot of, you know, endurance, I think.
Concentration, whatnot, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Timing.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Because you're traveling a long distance in a short period of time.
Logistics are killer sometimes.
Yeah. So absolutely.
We already, even on this little tour, we already went from one spot, and why we had to go up to another spot and come back down to that spot and come back over. It's too bad the routing just didn't go like that, but it was you know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it ends up, you end up spending a lot of time
drinking Foy Tonic.
Drinking Foy Tonic.
Me too, really.
Yeah. We actually have drinking games with Foy Tonic. It's pretty fun.
Yeah.
I think just one last question. You're sort of, want to get your thoughts on the state of sort of music right now, especially metal.
Yeah.
And we sort of touched earlier, not in this interview, but just off camera, about fans not going to see opening bands, but only seeing the headliners. And is sort of metal taking a back seat, kind of? Like, no.
I really don't think so, no. I mean, when bands can continuously keep on releasing albums and still tour.
Yeah.
Metal's such a large thing now, you know, where it goes from, whether it goes from, you know, European death metal to, you know, George Lynch and Dokken type stuff.
Yeah, it's branched out quite a bit.
It's huge, right?
Yeah, a lot of genres.
There's a major genre in it, you know, so it's maybe not being played on the radio all the time, but hell yeah, just released a new album. Volbeat working on another album.
Dokken's released an album.
No, so I mean, it's still, it's there, man.
Yeah.
It might be hidden a bit.
Well, you know,
it's not in the public eye all the time. Right?
I'll tell you my thoughts about it. I mean, the fans of metal are, they are a dedicated sort, you know? I think that that metal will survive, despite, you know, pretty rough times in the music industry, I think.
Yeah, with the downloading and...
With all that, with all the downloading and that sort of thing. I mean, it makes it tougher on bands, but there's this connection, right? I mean, when I'm playing a Black Label Society show, you know, I'll come off the stage, go up front and watch Zach, and there's this feeling of connectedness, you know, that I feel with everyone around. That is, I mean, it's like being in church. That's what it's like. It's my version of church, really. To put it succinctly. And
but it is
Zach is
rock.
The priest.
Church rock.
And the folks who love the metal as much as we do. And you know, that feeling goes beyond the genre even. I mean, it's about that human connection.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
They're not gonna stop loving metal. Yeah. It's never gonna stop. You can't take it away.
And it shows every night. Every night they're there.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. Shaking, man.
That's never gonna stop. Yeah. You can't take it away. It's like a virus.
It's like herpes.
Yeah.
There forever, man.
Have you got that again? This is why we have a doctor on the tour.
That's right.
Fixes us up.
Is there anything you want to say before we before your notches get really cold?
You know, yesterday I got a phone call from Chad Gray from Hell Yeah, and he was feeling a little under the weather. I just wanted to make sure that he was. Well, this might not get to him because of timing, but I wanted to make sure that he was doing all right for the rest of the tour. That they're still continuing on.
Yep. Take it easy, man.
Damn right. So, Chad, if you see this, man, get better.
Yeah. Yes.
Yep.
Love you,
hopefully,
man.
Hopefully everything's
stay
working
sexy.
Out. Yeah. Stay sexy.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Awesome.
Thank you, Pete.
Thank you, Pete.